itself 24 hours. It's not possible. So it doesn't mean that those who are putting camera are honest and those who are not putting camera are corrupt. So that was sort of comments are coming. So I thought, okay, best thing is I record it. Anybody wants to see, they can see it. But at the same time, I don't want to publish it in the public domain. That's what I'm doing.
But cameras keep an eye on you people. That's very important.
Yeah, of course. I would actually want to say, like, you know, communicate with citizens that government departments, there's nothing to hide actually. So there's nothing wrong in it actually. But yes, if sometime it may look like the thin line between being open and going into publicity actually. So I don't want to cross it actually. I would like to be
Your colleagues will definitely criticize it because they will be caught on the camera. So you must be open to the public.
Exactly.
Don't fall for their
That is why I am still recording it actually.
Mr. Manivannan, do you also spy on officials? In other chambers, have you put some cameras?
No, I don't do that actually. I thought that some of the officers will be inspired and they will put cameras. But they are not actually. I think that's in the psyche, you know, like I am so surprised, sir. People wanted to keep things to themselves, never want to share it actually. It is there across actually. All of us wanted, I know, when we eat in the train and all, we try to keep it close to ourselves. We turn this side and eat actually. Lot of things we don't do it openly. So,
Mr. Manivannan, is it only that or is it worry of the corrupt officials?
Oh, could be actually. It could be. And sir, one more
thing. And lethargic officials.
Lethargy may be right because corrupt people are very intelligent. They don't take money in the office actually. Lethargy could be one reason actually. And one more thing is, when you're on the camera, you can't sit quiet. You do some work actually and people also understand how much time you're sitting in the chair. So that is why I think they didn't go for that. Probably I have inspired some of the people to at least to go for fixing the camera in the common lobby actually, where people can see whatever is happening.
Have you caught any official red-handed, lethargic as well as corrupt?
I found them lethargic. Corrupt though, I can say that I have caught people red-handed in the district where people are not so intelligent. In Bangalore, catching a person red-handed, it's not so easy. And if you can catch somebody, it will be only at the very low level actually. I mean, it will be like, you know, I don't want to spend my time into spying into the linemen and other people. But yes, any person thinks that there has been some problem because of corruption, I would say that please reach us. I am available in the phone, in the email actually. We will not allow any of BESCOM staff to harass anybody in the name of corruption. That much I can say.
If anybody is harassed by a corrupt official, can he approach you directly?
Definitely, definitely. I will give my cell phone number also, 966-33-69-333.
Can you repeat it, sir? Can you repeat it?
966-33-69-333. But one request, please SMS to me because if you make a call to me, most of the time it's in silent mode, I won't be able to reply. Then you will say that, this guy doesn't pick up the calls. SMS to me. Better idea will be to send an email to my mail ID, that's money1972.work@gmail.com. That will take care of it.
You respond, sir?
Yeah, yeah. I think the citizens of Bangalore, they ensure that the people, government, the city and the government are responsive actually.
Very good.
You are doing the same job, sir, when I remember that.
Mr. Manivannan, you should also keep an eye on linesmen. I'm not talking of cameras on linesmen.
Correct.
Because most of them do not attend to problems till they are bribed. Bribe may be 50 rupees, maybe 20 rupees, but till they are bribed, they don't attend to your problem. This is the common complaint from the consumer.
This is where I actually, to be very frank, don't have an answer. I am aware that people demand money. We try to introduce a system wherein we are supposed to give a thanks card to the public. And we thought that when the lineman give the thanks card, they won't feel like demanding for money. Then I realized one fellow gives thanks card, another fellow goes and asks for money actually. So it is a problem which I am not able to find a solution now. All I can say is two-way solution. One is motivate the people and let them realize that asking for money is a bad thing, which will take a long time. Other one is, if anybody asks for a bribe, let the public immediately call us in our, we have 24/7 helpline, 228-7-3333. They call in the number, if we respond actually. If the lineman know that if I ask for money and the person choose to give a complaint, I'll be in a problem, then they won't do it. But there's one more problem. If we do that, the lineman next time when some complaint comes, he will open the rule book. and they will come and start inspecting. So it's a, I would say that I'm not able to find a perfect solution.
Vicious circle.
If anybody is able to give a better solution, I'll be really thankful to him.
Sir, you have to think of solutions. You are
I agree. I know that it's I'm responsible, but I would like to, it doesn't stop me from seeking suggestion from people.
Absolutely.